Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the generalized block diagram of radar. So let's begin with the topic. In this topic of block diagram of radar, we are going to cover the various sections, and the sections are: first topic is description of typical pulse radar block diagram, which includes antenna system, duplexer unit, transmitter section, pulse modulator, waveform generator, power amplifier. Now let's move on to the block diagram of typical radar system. Now the block diagram of typical radar system consists of three main parts. The first part is transmitter section, the second part is receiver section, and third part is RF front end, which consists of antenna along with duplexer. So these three are considered as important part of the radar system. Now let's understand each section one by one. Now let's move on to the block diagram again. The transmitter section, if we look at the block diagram, then we will come to know that the designing of transmitter section is very much easy as compared to the receiver section. Now let's have a look, or let's discuss about the transmitter section. The transmitter section uses power amplifier or power oscillator. If it is a power amplifier, then crystalline traveling wave tube or transistor amplifiers are used. Or if it is a power oscillator, then magnetron oscillator is used. Magnetron oscillator is considered as the best choice for radar system. Now, in this case, the transmitter section generates a carrier signal, and this carrier signal is modulated by using a short rectangular pulses produced by waveform generator. Now here the function of pulse modulator is to turn on or turn off the modulation depending upon the sequence of input pulse received. Therefore, in the transmitter section, the pulse modulator is basically acts as a switch. Basically, the waveform generator produces the pulses at very low power. The power amplifier modulates the signal by turning on or off the modulators which are present in it depending upon the input signal received. The output of the power amplifier is further given to the antenna by using a waveguide or transmission lines. Now here one more block is present, that is nothing but the duplexer. Duplexer is basically a device which allows the antenna to be used either as a receiving antenna or transmitting antenna. Depending upon which unit controls the antenna, on that basis the antenna can be used as a transmitting antenna or receiving antenna. If the antenna is controlled by transmitting unit, then it acts as a transmitting antenna. And if the antenna is controlled by receiving unit, then it acts as a receiving antenna. So basically, duplexer performs function of both transmission as well as reception. The antenna used in this system is maybe a parabolic reflector or planar array. Now let's move on to the receiver. The receiver used in the radar system are always a super heterodyne receiver. It consists of low noise RF amplifier along with mixer and local oscillator. The mixer and local oscillator converts the RF frequency into intermediate frequency. It is always convenient in RF communication system to convert the high gigahertz frequency into intermediate frequency for many reasons. The first reason is, if the frequency is increases, then the bandwidth requirement of the filter is also get increased, and therefore because of that the selectivity of the filter is get reduced, and it is not possible for the system to select a one particular frequency which is required for the operation. The second reason is, for the higher value of frequency, large values of inductor and capacitors are required, and therefore the inductor and capacitors which are used in the circuit is required to be replaced with the strip antennas, which are very expensive, and therefore it is very much convenient to convert the high gigahertz frequency into intermediate frequency or IF frequency. So the next block present in the receiver is nothing but IF amplifier and match filter. When IF amplifier is get followed with the crystal diode, it forms a second demodulator or second detector. The IF amplifier is basically used to determine the signal bandwidth of the receiver section. Further, the IF amplifier, match filter, second detector or demodulator along with video amplifier forms an envelope detector, and it is used to detect the pulse modulation and rejects the carrier frequency. In Doppler shift modulator, instead of using an envelope detector, the envelope detector is get replaced by a phase detector. So finally, the signal will be present at the output, and at the output the decision is made whether the object is present or not. It is made on the basis of the threshold decision. If the value of the output signal is very much higher than the threshold value, then it is assumed that the target is present at certain location. And if the value is less than the threshold decision value, then it is assumed that the noise will be present in the signal. So it is very much critical to decide the threshold levels for detecting the presence or absence of the target. So this is what about the block diagram of radar system, which consists of three main parts, that is transmitter, receiver and RF front end. So now let's move on to the MCQ part. The first question is, following signals are used in the pulse radar operation, and the options are radar carrier with pulses, second option is only pulses, third option is radar carrier only, and fourth option is none of the above. So from these four options, we need to select which signals are used in the pulse radar operation. And the answer is radar carrier with the pulses. Because in the radar signal, the sine wave carrier is get modulated with the help of rectangular pulses generated by waveform generator. So here, the radar carrier with the pulses are used in pulse radar operation. The next question is, a match filter is characterized by sharp frequency response, filter with maximizing peak signal to noise ratio, filter with ripple in the passband, and fourth option is filter with maximum flat character. And the right answer is option number B, that is nothing but filter with maximum peak signal to noise ratio. So match filters are basically used to provide high value of signal to noise ratio of the output signal. So this is what about the block diagram of basic radar system, or we can say the block diagram of generalized radar system. The basic block diagram consists of only two blocks, that is transmitter, receiver and antenna. But the generalized block diagram gives a detailed information about each block of the radar system. So I hope you understand this topic of block diagram of radar system. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.